its latest family-friendly offering is the distinctive 500L MPW, the largest member yet of the 500 sub-brand, with space inside for up to 7 people. Think of it as a 500XL and you'll be along the right lines, for the MPW is essentially a longer-bodied version of the recently introduced 500L compact MPV. But whereas the regular 500L is pitched against the likes of Ford's B-Max, the MPW bridges the gap to the larger C-Max twins. Known as the living elsewhere in Europe, the 500L MPW, for multi-purpose wagon and even my personal world according to Fiat's marketing department, is claimed to appeal universally to men, women and children, who will appreciate its space, practicality and unique looks. Those looks are, unsurprisingly, the MPW's biggest talking point. Sure, it looks 500-esque from the front, but from there on in, it looks like what it is, a tall estate comf. However, not only does that elongated tail liberate up to 1,584 liters of cargo space, it's also more aerodynamic than the existing 500 liters, reducing both fuel consumption and wind noise, despite the 30 kilograms weight penalty for the additional bodywork. UK prices and specifications are yet to be finalized, but early indications suggest that the 5-seater 500L MPW will have a £750 price premium over the existing model, with the addition of a pair of extra seats adding a similar figure again. Even more space inside in standard form, the Fiat 500L MPW remains a versatile 5-seater estate with a sliding second row of seats but with an enormous 638-liter boot. In spite of Fiat pointing out that the MPW provides the most interior space for the external dimensions of a car in this class, you would have to regularly need to transport large amounts of cargo in order to justify the financial outlay over the existing 500L. Where it begins to make more sense is when you opt for the third row of seats and turn the MPW into a 7-passenger car. Fiat is at pains to describe it as a 5+2. Indicating that the rearmost chairs are suitable for children and smaller adults, so forget any ideas of ferrying about 6 burly rugby players with you. Even with the third row in use, and considering the 500L MPW's modest 4.35 meters length, there's still 168 liters of boot space, enough for 2 small suitcases. Regardless of the rest of the interior trim, the third row of seats are upholstered in black fabric which quickly and easily fold flat into the boot floor when not required. It's worth noting that in 5+2-seater guys, the middle row no longer slides fore and aft but is nevertheless spacious enough for 3 adults. Embracing the 500 fun factor as the 6th member of the Fiat 500 family, which is said to grow to 7 in 2014 with the introduction of the 4-wheel drive 500X. The MPW's take on the cheeky detailing of the diminutive 500 city car feels a little tenuous. It maintains the frontal styling theme of the bluff nose and a pair of oval headlight units at either side, but beyond that there's little that shouts 500 at you aside from the liberal application of badges. That said, there are a huge range of personalization options and with up to 282 color, wheel and interior schemes to choose from. The chances of seeing another 500L MPW identical to the one you have purchased are slim. Various designs of alloy wheels are on offer in 16 and 17 inch sizes, while the roof can be specified in the body color, white or black. Just 2 trim levels will be sold in Britain. Popstar is brighter and funkier with lots of body color detailing inside, while the lounge version caters for those looking for a more traditional taste and luxury. So expect beiges and greys to dominate the interior. Exact specifications and prices for the UK market are still to be finalized ahead of the expected September on sale date, but Fiat indicates that the MPW is likely to be slightly better equipped than the existing 500L. Economical to run from launch, the Fiat 500L MPW will be available with a choice of a single petrol engine and 2 diesels, all of which are turbocharged. Fiat's well-known 0.9-liter twin-air engine is the petrol choice, delivering 105 bhp and 145 Nm of torque to the front wheels through a 6-speed manual gearbox. With a claimed fuel consumption of 54.7 miles per gallon and CO2 emissions of 112 gkm, it offers a reasonable performance and economy balance. Greater frugality is offered by the 63.6 miles per gallon 1.3 liter multi-jet 2 diesel, with 85 bhp and 200 newton meters of torque delivered through a choice of manual and automatic MTA gearboxes, each with 5 speeds. At 110 gkm, it's the greenest power plant in the lineup. If diesel appeals but you need greater performance, then look at the 105 bhp 1.6 liter multi-jet 2. 320 Nm of torque is produced at just 1,750 revolutions per minute from this refined motor, but economy drops to 60.3 miles per gallon and 117 gkm of CO2. So, with the MPW appeal to buyers who want the chicness of the baby 500 in a versatile, 7-seater form? Read the complete Fiat 500 liters MPW review to find out. With no engine from launch offering more than 105 bhp, the 500 liters MPW is certainly no ball of fire, but that's in keeping with the soft and comfortable ethos of the car. Unlike many selling Cooper S versions of its competing Countryman range, there are no current plans to release an Abarth Fiat 500 liters MPW performance version, although the Italian firm didn't rule out the possibility either. Depending upon your needs, turbocharged petrol and diesel engines are on offer, all with manual gearboxes. If an automatic transmission is a necessity, then you're limited to Fiat's MTA gearbox on the smaller of the diesels. Petrol power: Fiat's familiar twin-air 8-cylinder petrol engine kicks off the 500 liters MPW range, but unlike the unit in its smaller 500 namesake, here it delivers a healthy 105 bhp at a high 5,500 revolutions per minute. With 145 newton meters of torque produced at 2,000 revolutions per minute, the twin-air powered MPW can reach 111 miles per hour and get to 62 miles per hour in 13.0 seconds. At 54.7 miles per gallon, fuel efficiency is good for a petrol engine hauling a car of this size around, although the 6-speed manual gearbox has to be worked to get the best out of it. Do so and it should emit just 112 gkm of CO2. Diesel derivatives: two versions of the overhauled Multi-Jet 2 family of diesel motors are on offer in the MPW 2, a 1.3 liter with 85 bhp and 200 Nm of torque at 1,500 revolutions per minute. The larger 1.6 liter with 105 bhp and 320 newton meters. The larger engine produces its pulling power from 1,750 revolutions per minute, making it particularly well suited for a variety of urban and motorway traffic conditions, although there is an initial lag in performance until the turbo comes on song. This can be swiftly overcome by dropping a gear, of course. With a top speed of 112 miles per hour, 104 miles per hour for the 1.3 and reaching 62 miles per hour in 12.2 seconds versus 15.4 for the smaller engine, many will find the larger engine suits them best, despite being 3.3 miles per gallon less efficient than the 1.3 at 60.3 miles per gallon. On an initial drive of the 1.6 liter, encompassing a mix of motorways and urban stretches, 48 miles per gallon was easily achieved. Manual gearboxes are standard on the diesel range: 5 speeds for the 1.3 liter, 6 for the 1.6 liter. The smaller engine can also be fitted with a 5-speed automatic at extra cost. Two further engines, both with 120 bhp, will arrive later, more than likely in early 2014. One is a more powerful version of the 1.6 liter diesel, while the other is the petrol-aft 1.4 liter jet. Performance and efficiency figures will be announced nearer the on-sale date. Despite its jelly mold appearance, the 500 liters MPW does not wallow along the road as though you're at the helm of a mobile blancmange. That said, it's unlikely to set your pulse racing or leave you with a huge grin on your face, but it does provide safe and secure handling for up to 7 occupants. Fiat has modified the 500 liters S suspension in its transition into the MPW, including fitting different anti-roll bars. As a result, the body of the car doesn't list shiplink as you take sweeping bends, but due to the soft, flat nature of the comfortable seats, you do feel your own body being pulled by gravitational forces. More bolstering on the seat sides would help here. Grippy tires ensure cornering is secure with little adjustment of the wheel required to correct the turn midway through bends, although there's little feel from the road transmitted to the driver's hands. There's more weight to the steering than in the smallest 500, as befitting the MPW's size, but it never feels heavy or cumbersome. Opting for larger 17-inch alloy wheels may provide some additional dynamism to the driving experience, but with lower profile tires, the ride quality, one of the MPW's strengths, is likely to suffer. If you've not sat in a Fiat for a while, then the interior of the 500-liter MPW may surprise you. Okay, you're not surrounded by a wealth of squeezable, soft-touch plastics that feel like they will outlast the car itself, but the quality of the resilient materials used for the majority of dashboard and door trim components is far from poor. Not only that, they feel well assembled with controls that are simple to operate and, in the main, logically sighted. What the interior doesn't feel like is a 500, which may be a disappointing factor for some. Popstar trim with its body-colored interior appliques feels the most youthful and similar to its little brother, but with conventional instruments arranged in a familiar way, the appeal of the 500 circles within circles instrument binnacle has been lost. Like the regular 500 liters, the MPW shares fittings with models such as the Panda & Co., with a similar layout too, featuring a row of buttons below the infotainment display. The screen itself is positioned a little lower than ideal, making you take your eyes away from the road momentarily longer, and the display itself is small, making the optional Satin of display difficult to glance at and understand. Some switch gear is less than intuitive too, such as the headlight beam adjustment, which, considering the weight that could be transported about in the MPW, it's a feature that might need to be adjusted regularly. Whereas most manufacturers provide a rotary switch to do this, the Fiat has separate buttons to raise and lower the beam, adding a degree of fiddliness that's not required. Sensibly, for a car that's destined for a life of transporting growing families around, for the Fiat 500-liter MPW, comfort has been a priority of its engineers. Front seats are generously proportioned for a compact car and prove comfortable and supportive however long the distance traveled. All-round visibility is superb, making the cabin feel airy even if the optional 1.5 square meter roof isn't specified. Opt for the standard 5-seater configuration and spaciousness in the second row of seats, which can be slid forwards and backwards, ranges from fine to colossal, with ample elbow and shoulder room too, although the seat itself is a fairly flat and shapeless affair. Tick the relevant option box and have your 500-liter MPW converted into a 7-seater, and you gain more than just a pair of additional passenger berths. Access to the third row of seats is easy as the second row tumbles completely out of the way and the door openings are wide, but due to their size and the reduced headroom, at best the extra seats are suitable for no larger than average-sized adults. Perhaps the biggest advantage of going 7-seater is the fitment of what Fiat calls flexible frequency suspension. By using an advanced design, the new components successfully soften the MPW's ride quality without making it wallow through bends. In principle, the suspension should be comfort optimized for whether there's just the driver in the car or they're accompanied by 6 passengers. When fitted, there's a perceivable advantage in ride comfort over the 5-seater MPW, with a greater number of road imperfections being ironed smooth before they have chance to be transmitted to the car's occupants. Thankfully, it doesn't make the 500-liter MPW floaty either, feeling composed and planted to the road. When the Fiat 500-liter MPW arrived in the UK in September 2013, it was available in just 2 trim levels: Popstar and Lounge. Standard Fiat 500-liter MPW equipment. Popstar 500-liter MPWs feature electric front windows, electric door mirrors, 16-inch alloy wheels, 6 airbags, electronic stability control, cruise control, air conditioning, dual drive steering with a city button to lighten the load in urban environments, rear parking sensors and a 5-inch U-Connect touchscreen for the radio and Bluetooth telephone functions. Progress up to lounge specification and the 500L MPW is equipped with more luxurious trims, all-round electric windows, tinted glass, automatically dimming rear view mirror, dusk sensing headlights, rain detecting wipers, dual zone climate control, rear privacy glass and an electric glass sunroof. Optional Fiat 500L MPW accessories. Fiat is keen for 500L MPW buyers to personalize their cars, so a huge range of wheels, colors and interior colorways can be selected, giving up to 282 permutations. This includes the option of having the roof painted in the body color, or opt for a distinctive black or white contrast. Other choices from the chocolate box of extra cost options include a reversing camera which spies out of the central zero in the tailgate's 500 badge, an enormous 1.5 square meter electric glass sunroof, sat nav, audio streaming and DAB radio via the U-Connect infotainment system and an integrated espresso machine. Yes, you did read that correctly, which sits between the front seats. Of course, the option that's likely to add the most value to your 500L MPW is the apostrophe plus two-third row of seating. It's not particularly cheap at an estimated £750, but it adds to the versatility of the car without compromising boot space in five-seater mode. Plus, the more compliant suspension fitted as part of the package helps iron out more road imperfections than the standard damping can manage. Considering the 500L MPW's small size, its safety levels are quite high. Although the MPW hasn't been tested by the technicians at Euro NCAP, the shorter 500L hasn't scored a full 5 stars. Standardized Fiat 500L MPW safety features include 6 airbags, with 2 up front, a pair at the side and a couple running the length of the window line. A driver's knee airbag is optional. Additionally, ABS, an electronic stability system and up to 7 3-point seat belts, with ice-fix mountings on the outer 2 of the middle row of seats complete the picture. Optional safety kit can be specified at extra cost, with the city brake control likely to be a popular and welcome addition. Constantly monitoring the road for objects in the car's path, the system automatically brakes the car in order to avoid a collision. Insurance companies are starting to take such systems into account and may reduce premiums for cars fitted with it. Also useful given the 500L MPW's size is the availability of rear parking sensors and a reversing camera that's mounted in the central zero of the 500 badge on the tailgate. By definition, a multi-purpose wagon has to be flexible or there's little point in buying one. Sensibly, for the Fiat 500L MPW, practicality was the designer's mantra. Fiat claims the MPW has the greatest amount of interior volume for a car of this class, with the feeling of spaciousness being backed up by the tape measure. In 7-seater mode, the boot can hold 168 liters of luggage, useful enough for about 5 supermarket carrier bags. Flip the levers on the seat backs and the 5,053rd row of seats fold flat into the boot floor, increasing capacity to 638 liters of uncluttered load space. The wide tailgate opens high, with a wide opening and a low loading lip making loading and unloading a painless experience. Need more space? Then fold the middle row of seats, split in a 6,040 configuration, both flat to the boot floor line, or with an additional handle pull, tipping forwards against the front seats. Not only is boot space now a gigantic 1,584 liters, but the load bed is now 2.6 meters long. It's not finished there either, as the front passenger seat tips forwards to accommodate even longer loads. Fitted with a hard plastic covering, not only is the seat back protected from the worst a visit to the DIY center can throw at it, it usefully doubles as a tabletop. If the space wasn't appealing enough, the Cargo Magic Space system allows you to partition the boot off, separating fragile and heavy items from each other, or simply keeping dirty things from clean ones. Spending time inside the 500L MPW will give you the opportunity to familiarize yourself with the location of all 22 cubby holes, with the air-conditioned upper glove box, large enough to chill two 500 milliliters drinks bottles, being especially welcome at the height of summer.